Because for those that says all lives matter, when we say black lives matter, or that says blue lives matter, to come back, when you say black lives matter, you're racist. Because I'm a black lives matter before a blue lives matter. And today was unacceptable. Today is the behavior that law enforcement officers should not exhibit. So I'm just gonna tell y'all what happened to me this morning on the way to work in this uniform. This is a federal uniform. So I'm driving down 65 North, traveling to Huntsville. And I see Blount County, I know where they sit every day. I see the officer with the radar gun. My front two windows are down. Each morning to work, I listen to my inspirational music on Pandora, because it's a dangerous road. I travel 1,000 miles a week. So my windows are down. I'm just in my spiritual mood. I see him with the gun, radar gun. I knew that I was going to get stopped. Wasn't speed. Wasn't doing anything. I knew I was going to get stopped because I'm used to being stopped because of my vehicle and because I'm black. Now, this is someone that's been in law enforcement for 15 years. So, I go ahead and get over in the center lane because I know I'm going to be the one that, I see him come out, I know I'm going to be the one that stopped. See him get behind me, he turns on his lights, and I make a phone call, get my girlfriend on FaceTime so she can see this and hear. He comes up to my window and he sees my uniform. But I will say, I asked him immediately, and you all have the right to know why you are being stopped. Because when I was trained back in 2005 as an officer, deputy, a law enforcement officer, approach your window, they are supposed to give their name. I am officer such and such, and I am deputy such and such, and the reason that I stopped you today. Well, he come up to my window real aggressive like, and I asked him, I said, why did you pull me over? I have that right to know, because I know that I wasn't speeding. I know that I wasn't swerving, I wasn't doing anything. And I know that he was running radar. So if you're running radar and you're stopping me, you're insinuating that I was speeding. But anyway, so he tells me, well, you were following too close. And I said, following too close? And you had your phone, you were on your phone. I said, I wasn't on my phone. That's how I was listening to my gospel music. So then he says, oh, hey, yeah, she works for customs. And then he turns on his mic. He said, oh, yeah, because this, I can feel a complaint coming. So now me working for customs had nothing to do with the stop. That was just him being intimidated by my position. Okay. It was him being intimidated, young white officer. So then he's kind of mouthing me, and me being who I am, and those of you that know who I am and how I am, you're not going to disrespect me, period. I told him, either you're going to write me a ticket or you're not. And he told me, I sure am. Okay, fine. The other officer comes to the window. Do you have driver's license? Well, what kind of question is that? I mean, I am sitting here in a federal uniform. You would think that I, right, assume that I have a license, right? I hand him my license. And then he says, well, I need a registration. Now, for those that do not know, when you register your tag, you have to have insurance, right, in this state. And it is linked because The system's a lot better when I was a deputy at Jefferson County, okay? They can see your insurance. Well, I said, sir, can't you, y'all can pull that up, right? No, not out of state. Well, my tag is Alabama. Okay. I'm looking for my registration as I show him my proof of insurance first on my phone. And then he asks for registration now, y'all. He's taking me down through that now. He's every little thing he can do. Let me see your registration. Now you know you can run the tag, y'all, and see that my tag is valid and it is current. But anyway, he wants to see my registration. So I dig through my glove box. I'm trying to find it, and he's steadily, the other officer is steadily kind of tonguing at me. You think you above the law? I said, excuse me, how do you think I'm above the law? How do you think that I'm above the law? Because I didn't ask for a break. Hell, if anything, I said, give me a damn ticket. I didn't ask for a break. So I find my registration. He looks at that, but all along, he's trying to provoke me, okay? And I told him, I said, sir, I will not argue with you. I'm not going to go back and forth for you. I'm not going to argue with you. So I say, I'm trying to simply give you what you asked for. That's what I'm trying to do. So then he tells me that, you just something about me having an attitude. I said, let me ask you a question. Do you know me? I said, because if you don't know me, you don't even know me well enough to even know if I do have an attitude. How are you going to meet somebody right away and know in that moment if they have attitude or if they're sad or if they're anything about, you don't even know them. You don't know me to know whether or not I have an attitude. So y'all, he come back to the window with these two tickets. Okay. Texting and driving. Now, I could pull my phone record up. I wasn't on the phone. I wasn't texting. I was listening to Pandora, John Peakey station, to be exact. Texting and driving and falling too close. Now, let me tell y'all something. Let me educate y'all. Every law enforcement officer in this country know if I write you a ticket for following too close, I'm just giving you a ticket. Okay? Because according to the law, it's every 10 miles per hour, there should be 20 feet. So if you're going 70, what's that? 70 feet. Now, how many people got 70 feet in between each car? So technically, we all follow too close, right? So we know if you get that ticket or you're given that ticket, that's that cop being a butthole. So I get the tickets. And he tells me, my name is such and such and such. If you want to complain, and the city hall is here. And I said, okay. I wrote his name. As I'm writing his name down, he tells me it's on the ticket. And then let me go back, y'all. He said, well, I know you enforce federal law, but state law. I said, I stopped. I'm saying, I enforced state law for 9 years. As a deputy sheriff. So he's looking at me and thinking this black female and taunts me that's got a federal job with customs, whoop-de-doo. This is how he acts now, okay? But he didn't know my background. He don't know that I've been doing this for 15 years. I know the law, state, local, and federal. I know that. So I get my tickets. I'm upset. I'm so mad, y'all, that I'm crying because I'm angry. I'm angry for a lot of reasons. I'm angry because as a black female, I have had so many bad run-ins with the police, even as a police. So when I hear black males talk about experiences, when I hear those, I don't discredit them. I know that there are facts. I know what they're saying is the truth. To be honest with you all, the way that this traffic stop happened and was conducted today, had I been in civilian clothes, and it would have went differently. I do believe that in my mind and my heart that things would have went a lot differently had I been in civilian clothes. And that's why we have these shootings. Because what happens is when you question the police and they don't like that, they get angry. They get upset. So when they get upset and they get angry, they forget about everything that they were trained on. They forget about everything that you're supposed to do. They forget about the fact that when you put this uniform on, you're actually held to a higher standard than the next person. You're actually supposed to have a thicker skin than the next person. So when somebody do get an attitude with you, when somebody do curse you, you still supposed to stay in character. Now, when your character messed up, it's just messed up in this uniform. Now, that's a fact. But this is what you're supposed to do. That's your job. That's what you're supposed to do. So for me, it just, my feelings, my emotions, I just erupted. I was angry. Like right now, I was supposed to go to Huntsville. I can't even go to work because I was that mad and I was that upset. Because my girl had to tell me, stop reaching for stuff. Because they were back there. They, you know, I'm looking, I'm trying to put stuff in. She's like, stop all that moving. I told her, I ain't stopping nothing. Now, that was a very good point of hers. Because the way they was acting, it really didn't matter about me being in no uniform. It did not matter. That meant nothing. So I call my supervisor. I tell her what's going on. I tell her that you don't know what I've been experiencing when I have to travel from Birmingham to Huntsville 5 days a week and me traveling through Kimberly on numerous occasions to get to 65, being stopped, harassed, and followed. To the extent, y'all, that I was looking in Kimberly to purchase a home, that I no longer considered that area because I was being harassed coming through there. I shared all these things with her and she had no idea. Of course, I hate to say it, people don't want to talk about this, but white people don't know what we go through, what we experience. I don't expect you to understand because you won't understand. You won't understand me wanting to move closer to Huntsville because that's where I live. And that would take 30 minutes off my commute every day each way. But I can't do that because I'm being harassed. You don't know how that feels. And I drive to Blount County Police Department. So me and the chief, we went in his office. And we talked a good 30 to 45 minutes. And the chief, old school, probably been in law enforcement, probably as old as I am. And you know what he told me, y'all? This is what's going to get y'all. He said, they don't even write tickets. So what they tell y'all? I got this one with them. I got these two. But they don't write tickets. They really don't write tickets. So that means my black butt was getting them today. And that means that it's like, y'all, I'm kind of like lost for words, man, because it's like, they like, you ain't getting this ticket, but we don't write them, but you getting it, right? So he says, get out of my car, get off this. All right, y'all, back to business. So what that means for real though, if they don't really write tickets, but they wrote me a ticket, but then he also said that the other guy, the Turner guy, is a interdiction guy. So what does that mean? Interdiction, for y'all that doesn't know, they're looking for drugs. They're looking for money. Okay? That's where interdiction. If you got an officer or you see those units that says interdiction and stuff like, they're not looking for speeders. They don't care about that. They are looking for drugs, okay? So that tells me if they really don't write tickets, then you looked at my vehicle, my windows were down. You knew I was black and you probably thought I was a man with this haircut. So you said, ooh, I got a good one. That's what that tells me. And I know
That's what it was about. So with all that being said, y'all, A, know the law, okay? B, be careful. Because if this happened to me in my uniform, then what's the level that it really would have went to if I wasn't? Now, when I opened my armrest and asked for my license, there was a gun there. So let's say I didn't have my shirt on. And let's say that when he asked for my license and he saw that gun, he would have shot my ass. He would have shot me because he was already young. He was already just overzealous, right? And he was already intimidated. But let's just remove the shirt. Let's take the shirt off, just the black t-shirt. And he asked for my driver's license. And I opened that armrest. And that gun was right there. He would have shot me. And guess what? He would have got off. Because when they came and did the crime scene, y'all. And I'm dead. And they opened that armrest up. He would have said, I saw a gun. And she reached for it. And then he would have got off. And then they would have removed the gun. And under the gun, they would have saw my badge and credentials. And he would have shot and killed a federal officer.